Now that you are within the underworld, see that there is a light in the distance. A bright light within the darkness. This is the light of your soul, of your spirit. That exists in all the world, the underworld, in the middle world, in the higher world. It is this very light which binds all worlds together. It is also the center of the underworld, the heart of it. So as you go there, you will feel that the darkness is deepening all around you. That you're, in a way, walking away from the light, while at the same time walking towards the light. Because you're leaving your normal consciousness, which is related to the daytime in the astral. And you're heading into the consciousness of spirit, which is in the heart of darkness. Because your divine self, encased in illusions, in memories. And to find your true self, you will have to pass through this area of illusions, fears. For only then can you find your true self. So do not waver, but continue. Not hastily, but with a steady pace. Knowing that to become one again with spirit is your goal, is your purpose. That together with your animals, you can overcome any obstacles on your path, any challenges on your way. As you get nearer to the light, see that it is as a huge bonfire. Several feet across, burning, creating a small circle of light, contrasting the darkness. Go into the circle of light. Become one with the heart of your world, with your own spirit. And feel how the light and the warmth of the fire nestle within your body. Warmed by your own spirit, supported by it, take your place in the circle. Sit down. Relax. And feel the growing harmony between your consciousness and the consciousness of your spirit. And how, as you become one, all the blockages and barriers between lives, between situations, start to fall away. As you let go, and all the illusions are burnt away by the fire. And feel that there are other yous, other parts, that you're next to you, that you're supporting you on your path. Allow them to take their place in the circle, to come forward out of the darkness, and also to become in harmony with the Spirit. Look at all these other parts of yourself. Sometimes it helps to give them a name. They can be the happy you, the cranky you, the angry you. They're all parts of you, all the different faces you wear in different situations. Ask them why they exist, why are they here with you. Start with the ones which are next to you, which are similar to you. Part of you are they trying to protect? Because ultimately every mask is also a guardian, trying to make sure that your spirit does not lose its way. Feel the support, the strength you get from not being alone in your struggle, but having all these companions next to you to take over when they're called upon, to help you to fight, to help you to relax, to help you to think. Try to look also at the ones who are opposite from you, on the other side of the fire. The ones you've pushed away, who are no longer next to you, working together with you. Why are they still here? Why do they feel rejected by you? Maybe some of them want to dissolve. Invite them to go forward to the fire, to become one with the fire, to go back to the source, as they're no longer needed. Some may have to stay where they are, waiting in readiness until they're called upon again, when the situation becomes such that they will need to step forward and protect you. Some you might want to invite to come closer to your side, so that their power, their talent, can manifest more often, more readily in your life. So make a place for them at your side. And ask them to come with you. To join you. To work together with you. And changing your life. Take some time to get to know all the members of your inner tribe, all the different masks and sub-personalities, and work together also with your spirit guides who are still with you, though they are slightly behind you in the darkness. Let's see if you can form a nice team, nice group, a harmonious group. So you will be able to progress and to serve your spirit. But you can imagine that you're smoking a peace pipe, blowing the smoke through a hollow bone, because you yourself are that peace pipe. You yourself are the hollow bone through which spirit is blowing its breath, blowing its gifts, is moving its life. And share your body with them by sharing the pipe with them. Feel that spirit blows through you and blows through all of you, cleaning you, harmonizing you, making you one in purpose. The peace pipe is also present in the body. It's the prana tube connecting all the different chakras together, connecting all the different you to each other. And feel how the spirit, the power of the spirit, is moving up and down through the prana tube as you spend time with the fire. Our power is rising up from the lower chakras, how harmony and beauty is descending from the higher chakras. By blending these two things, beauty and power, we are made into a harmonious being. Take as long as you need here, next to the fire of your spirit. When you're done, we'll move to the next video and start our journey back to our normal waking consciousness.